Previously on the Fugitive Chickens. Chapter 3, A Big Mountain of Fury. The animals went past the speed limit and went much ahead from the chef. The chef cried,
"Oh, come on! It's so unfair! I'm on a skateboard and they are in a car!"
The narrator said, "The author said so don't cry about it." The chef thought, "If I can't handle them, I'll call for reinforcements." The chef said,
What's the number of 911? Oh, forget it, I'll call the animal control."
The animal control was right behind the animal's car. The animal screamed. Zini shouted to the raccoon, "Drive faster, faster!" The raccoon said,
"But I will break the speed limit!"
Zini shouted,
"Keep on going!"
The raccoon said,
"But I have to wait till the green light comes! I live in the city, so I have to follow the rules!"
In any case, the raccoon did it because the animal control truck was getting too close. The raccoon closed his eyes and spinned the wheel blindly because he was getting too scared. They drove on top of a donut shop with a big donut on it, and they struck the giant donut and the donut fell off the building and started to roll on the ground. The animals continued driving after they crashed. A police officer and a shopkeeper were eating donuts with a fresh mug of coffee. The police officer said to the shopkeeper that he needed to catch the animal's car. The animals kept on driving while the giant donut was right beside their car. Suddenly, the chef came. The animals stopped. They were surrounded by the police officer, the animal control, and the chef. The three people came slowly to the animal's car. The animals needed to think fast.
"Listen, we can't drive left, right, backwards, or forward. So how about we drive
upward?"
said Ryotas. The raccoon and Zini said at the same time,
"Ryotas, it's impossible to drive upward."
Ryotas said angrily,
"So let me try it at least."
Ryotas drove upward. And all the others' jaws fell to the ground. Ryotas started to drive too high. Zini said as they reached space,
Ryotas, I think you're driving a bit too high."
Ryotas screamed,
"Oh no! I can't drive downwards!
They had to jump out of the car. They landed on a cloud. Ryotas said,
"Phew! We landed on the snow."
The raccoon said, confused,
It doesn't snow."
They all screamed as they were falling. They landed on a trampoline and bounced to a restaurant. The waiter screamed,
"Ah! These three filthy animals!"
He called the janitor. The janitor got a broom. They ran to a clothes shop. The janitor was waiting for them outside to capture them. The animals came out of the clothes shop with tuxedos and sunglasses. The janitor caught them and became confused because they didn't look like animals. The animals said with the most serious voice they can make,
"Not as serious as mine."
"What are you doing? Are you a restaurant janitor? Oh, don't tell me that you forgot to tell you that I was the VIP that was going to your restaurant."
The janitor was shocked and started to respect the animals, and the janitor led their way to the restaurant. They were in the restaurant. The waiter said,
"What do you want for your dinner, sir? Everything is for free, just for you."
The animals replied,
I would like everything on the menu.
The waiter gave steak, soup, and blah, blah, blah. You know what I mean. The animals were confused on what this was. The raccoon said,
I guess I have to start eating."
He poured the soup onto his hands to drink the soup. A waiter passed them and was so confused about what the VIPs were doing. Ryota said,
I guess I'll start eating."
He was eating the plate instead of the steak. The same waiter passed by and was even more confused about what the VIPs were doing. Zany said,
I guess I'll have to start eating.
He ate the bones of the fish! I need a water break. The waiter was so confused that he told the chef, and the chef told the janitor. The janitor went to see their table. The janitor said, as she saw the raccoon's tail,
Hold on a second.
He removed the clothes and saw their true colors. The animals ran away. The janitor couldn't keep up, so she just gave up. The animals were running, and they just bumped into the chef. He said in an evil voice,
Well, if it isn't the three rascals. No longer frighten me, Mr. Raccoon, because I found your weakness. It is perfumes. Why? Because it stink!
While the chef was busy talking, the animals had already run away. The chef had become too furious. He gave up. And I said angrily, No! Don't you even think of giving up! The otter and the readers don't like it one bit. The chef said disappointedly,
Why does no one like the ideas I make?
He thought,
How about I get 50 bodyguards? Nah, I'll read the news and history books and all the people will laugh at me.
He started to cry. The animals came. Zany gave some tissue paper to the chef. The chef sobbed.
Thank you, Zany. Wait a second.
They started running. No, don't close the book, you tricky readers. Read more. We don't want to get squashed by the book cover. Just continue. The animals were being chased by the chef. The raccoon suddenly stopped and looked at the billboards. All of them were written,
These three animals will cause this always destruction. Like destroying a door shop and stealing thousands of clothes and cars. If caught with them, you will get a reward of 10,000 cash. Give them to a chef.
While the raccoon was reading, the chef captured him. Riotus and Zany were confused where the raccoon went. They realized what the billboard said. They knew that the raccoon got caught. The chef told the police that he got the raccoon. The police said,
Nah, you won't get the reward.
The chef was shocked and angry. The police continued,
You see, this raccoon is gonna taste horrible for my dinner, but those two chickens would be a dream to eat.
The chef was so mad. His face was bright red and steam was coming out from his ears. He left the building and threw his shoe out of anger. Someone grabbed his shoe. What are the odds? The chef shouted,
No! Give them back! Oh, whatever. That shoe had a rat inside it. I need an idea to get those chickens. Oh, that's a great idea! Ah, but that's a better idea.
His idea was cooking pizza? The chef continued,
You know what? I'm gonna do the idea about getting the chickens.
Wait, his shoe had a rat inside it? You.
Ah! Wait, no!
Oh yeah, free shoe.
20 minutes later.
Thank you for saving me from nothing.
The raccoon said happily. The chicken smiled. There was an awkward silence for some time. And then finally, Zany said confused,
Is it just me or are all the people of New Delhi chasing us?
The raccoon looked back and said,
I think it's just you.
Riotus agreed. They all walked happily after all. And that lasted for 2 seconds. They looked behind and saw the people of New Delhi. They had very wide eyes and they had sweat dripping everywhere. And then, you know it, they had to run. They all closed their eyes and pinched themselves while running because they thought they were in a dream. And they by accident split up because they were closing their eyes. The raccoon went to a supermarket. Zany went to a cinema. Riotus went to an apartment. The raccoon said,
"We should be safe here. Xenia and Leotis? Wait a minute. Where are Xenia and Leotis?" Bang! Bang! Bang!
The raccoon went to see what's outside the window. He saw one quarter of the citizens of New Delhi trying to break in. He said in fear,
"Oh no! I should use these cards to block the door from opening. Oops! It's no use! Maybe this pencil I found from the counter will help it."
He placed the pencil in front of the cards. He smiled and did a thumbs up. He continued,
"Much better."
The door rapidly opened a little. The raccoon pushed it as hard as he could. It was too hard for him. He pushed anything he could find at the store to place it in front of the door. He finally blocked it from opening. He cleared, but then he realized that all he had to do was lock the door. "What?" he shouted in anger. His stomach growled, so he picked some stuff to eat at the store. He then became very fat. Ryotis was confused where he was. He was also confused where the others were. But he didn't care that much about where the others were. All he did was play around. He was dancing and playing games on the computer he saw on a desk. He then went to the bathroom. He saw a person doing and didn't need to mention it. He just ignored him and went out of the bathroom. He did other fun stuff. But then suddenly the roof of the apartment went off. It was held by a helicopter. Ryota screamed and ran away. The person in the bathroom shouted,
"My beautiful house!"
Xeni was also confused where he was, like the other two. He went to the movie room with the big screen, but he heard a crowd rushing here. He tried to close the door, but it was too hard for him. He was confused about how to block the door or them from coming in. He gave up and just watched the movie. People burst in the door, looking for him. They saw him on the top seat in the room. They caught Xeni and he was cooked by the chef. Wait a minute, that doesn't sound right. Let me see what was on page 10. I see. Okay, sorry for the disturbance. So Xeni said,
"Want some popcorn?"
The people got distracted and watched with Xeni. After they watched the 3-hour movie, one person said surprised,
"Hey guys, do you know that there are 2 chickens and 1 raccoon on the run? And if you catch them, you'll get a reward of 10,000 rupees. And one of the chickens looked exactly like the chicken that watched a movie with us. Let's get him." Oh, he's already ran. Typical. "But we'll get him!"
The people ran after Xeni. Xeni, Ryotis and the raccoon bumped each other. The crowd ran and caught up to them. But they couldn't find the animals because there were so many people and the little animals were small compared to them. The animals were ducking and hoping they wouldn't find them. One person found them and shouted,
"I found them!"
He tried to catch them, but then he bumped into another person, and that person bumped to another person, and that person bumped to another person, and so on. And all the people fell down like dominoes, and that was the animals' golden opportunity to escape. The animals got out of the crowd, but the animals bumped into the chef again, and another kid. They ran to the jungle and bumped into Sasquatch. Xeni whispered,
"I never knew Sasquatch has lived in the subcontinent."
The Sasquatch said in a grumpy voice,
No, it's just that in the forest in America, they have no luxury. Another reason is that India, they barely think I am real. And another reason is that India, the chickens are more tasty."
The animals were running away from the Bigfoot and bumped into the chef. The chef said, terrified,
"Is that a Sasquatch?"
The chickens ran away because the Sasquatch was distracted by the chef. The Sasquatch said,
"Sup, it's the mighty and fierce Bigfoot. By the way, I really wanted those chickens, so can you cook them for me? I promise I won't attack you. Promise, because you ain't looking tasty." Yeah.
The Sasquatch put out his big hand. The chef accepted the deal and he smiled evilly. So the chef and the Sasquatch sat and were thinking of strategy to capture them.
Ah!